Welcome to the Insight Channel. I'm James Kilroy, and today I'm going to be taking you through the Surface Pro 3. I'm going to break down the main features and talk about the Surface Pro 3 replacing a traditional desktop or laptop. So let's run through some of the key specs. The first thing you'll notice is the amazing glossy 12-inch screen. This is running at 2160 by 1440 resolution. That's up to 216 ppi from 207 on the previous version. So I'm just going to switch it on. And we've actually got this logged in and we're using it on our Insight network. So I've just got to pop in a really secure password there, Insight1. We will be changing that. So Microsoft have gone with a 3.2 aspect ratio and they claim that the screen at 12.2 inches can display more content than laptops running 1610 on a 13.3 inch screen. So especially when you hold it in the portrait mode. You'll also notice that they've switched the Microsoft Home button from the horizontal bottom panel to the vertical panel to encourage people to use it more in a traditional notepad way. And it does feel quite comfortable in that position. So the machine is running Windows 8.1 Pro. You've got your free upgrade to Windows 10. That's a good enablement platform for Office 365. It comes with fourth generation processors. Either an Intel Core i3, i5 or i7. You can have 4 or 8 gigabytes of RAM, SSD storage of either 64, 128, 256 or 512 gigabytes, and there's also a micro SD expansion port. It has two cameras, one on the back and also one on the front, both 5 megapixel and both able to record video at 1080p. All the usual connectivity, standard Wi-Fi connection, and Bluetooth 4, and they're boasting a battery life of up to 9 hours. We haven't actually been able to test that yet, but it's lasted a full day with general use. The machine is also really thin, only 0.36 inches. It's very small and portable, and it weighs in at just 1.76 pounds. We will be doing a side-by-side comparison with the Surface Pro 2 to show you that a bit later. Pricing is starting from $5,399 for the i3 version, right up to $1,349.99 for an i7 with 8 GB of RAM and 512 GB storage. This particular one is running an i5 and has 4 GB of RAM. Okay, so another massive improvement from Microsoft is the new pen. It's got improved usability with OneNote. It's been weighted a hell of a lot better to feel more like an actual pen. It's got a nice premium aluminium finish, and I must say it does feel just like a normal pen in the hand. It uses Bluetooth to connect, and it's powered by Intrig. It now apparently tracks a lot closer to the physical position than ever before, thanks to some major improvements to the actual Surface screen itself. This particular version, we've got the two button version. This one selects a raise function, and this one is a select function for highlighting text, etc. So let's jump into OneNote and have a little play with it. I am a lefty, so I do apologize for my writing. It's not the best even with a normal pen. So just write a few bits and bobs here. Yeah, that's good. You can lean your hand on the screen. It doesn't affect what you're writing. And I can select the erase function to get rid of anything I don't like. And if you want to do the select function, select some text, move it around the screen if you want. Fantastic. Okay, so a quick overview of the ports on the device. We have the volume rocker here and the headphone jack. If we twist it around this way, you've got the power on button, power off button. Down this side, you have a mini display port, USB port, and your power charging jack. And also just underneath the hinge, you have expansion for micro SD as well. Okay, so then we have another great improvement on the Surface Pro 3 is the friction hinge. This now enables you to set it in lots of different positions instead of just one. And when you bring in the type cover, the optional extra, a little under 82 pounds, snap that on. You can see you've got a real good looking notebook and you can adjust this hinge into multiple different positions. You've also got a secondary hinge now on the type cover itself, which clicks up there. Microsoft have coined the phrase lappability, which is the ability to actually use this on your lap. The Surface Pro 2 wasn't very good at letting people do that. With these two adjustable hinges, now you can do that. You've also got a more premium look and feel to the type cover and a nice clickable proper trackpad as well. So let's just do a quick side-by-side comparison against the Surface Pro 2. A lot heavier, by the way. And when I put them together, you can see it's also a lot thicker, the Surface Pro 2. So much better machine, a lot more advanced as you would expect. Very good specifications for the money as well. And the ability to really use this device at home on your lap, in the office as a desktop or laptop replacement, as a tablet, out in the field, taking notes, doing demonstrations, etc. So our question at the start of this video is whether the Microsoft Surface Pro 3 truly does replace your classic desktop or laptop. Our Insight users say it definitely does.